Today, we're taking a look at an amazing software called Figma. Figma is great for collaborating, designing, and prototyping, perfect for UX designers, web designers, or designers of all sorts. Hi, my name is Sara. I work full-time as a product designer, and I also run my own freelance business from home. If you're new here, make sure you click the subscribe button, and all the links I've mentioned in this video, you can find them in the description below. If you want to have a closer look at my life as a designer, you can find me every day on Instagram. So, now let's jump into this video. In the last video, we looked at my 5 best wireframe and prototyping tools, and one of them was actually Figma. I've been designing websites in Figma for over 2 years, and because I've been doing this for so long, I created a kind of formula to help me speed up my workflow, and I'm super excited to share it with you. But first, what is Figma? Figma is a design and collaborating tool, and basically you can do anything from producing wireframes, prototypes, component libraries, and invite everybody to collaborate with you in real time. Make sure you stick around to the end because I'm gonna share with you some tips to help you collaborate in Figma with clients and developers. Now, let's jump into it. I love Figma because I can manage the whole design project in one place and avoid the stress of constantly having to email my clients or having to deal with hundreds of documents, emails, pictures, fonts, and so on. Of course, I still have emails and documents, but way less than you probably think. First, we're gonna look at how I use pages to organize my Figma files. Each page represents a different stage in the design process. Let me show you. For this website, I've created 7 pages, so I can do massive brainstorming on one, put the finished design in another one, and so on. The first page includes mood boards, snapshots, and any kind of random file that I can use as a starting point. The second one is dedicated to user research, which means I'm gonna add any kind of information about the users to help the creation of user personas and empathy mapping. On the third page, I've got the wireframe stage, which doesn't look very exciting, but it's super important as it allows me to explore different solutions without spending too much time on the details. I split the final design into desktop and mobile as each page holds his own prototype, which makes it easy to run user tests for different platforms or screen sizes. In the component library, we can find all the reusable components such as buttons, tabs, headings that I've used multiple times in the file. Having a system like this in place helps maintain consistency, speed up the design process, and it helps developers understand the logic behind any design decisions. Last but not least, the draft folders where with all the ideas my clients and I have decided not to use, but I want to keep in case I want to use them in future projects. There isn't a right or wrong way to organize pages, as every company, team, and individuals have unique needs, but because Figma is so flexible, you can organize your design files in the way that works best for you. Alright, we've just seen how to organize pages, and now we're gonna look at the components. By clicking on Assets on the top left, we can see all the components I've created for this project. There are basically 2 kinds of components. Master components define all the properties of a component, while component instance is the copy of the master component. On this panel, we've got the component instances that we can drag into pages, while in the component library, I keep all the master components. Instances are linked to the master components, so if we want to change the master components, all the component instances will automatically change. Building a high-quality component system is not easy and it takes time. Honestly, I don't always follow a rigid structure when it comes to organizing and labeling components, as some of my website projects are very simple, but for sure having a component library in place helps a lot. When I first started using Figma, I didn't know the benefits of using master components, so my designs were often inconsistent and my process was much slower. So what I want to say to you is that you need to find a balance between building a high quality component library and don't use it at all. And you can do this by assessing the complexity of the website you are designing. Are you designing a blog, an e-commerce, or a simple landing page? Is it scalable? Most importantly, speak with a developer and try to understand what information they actually need from your Figma file to achieve the best results. All right, we've just seen how we organize pages and components, and now let's talk about resources and plugins. You probably have noticed that all my Figma files have something in common, and that's because they all come from the same template that I've used as a starting point for all my projects. This helps me speed up my workflow and make sure I'm not missing anything important. This is where all my web design project starts. It's called the web design template. Yeah, I'm very creative with names. There's not much to show here as all pages are blank except for the component library that I can use as a starting point for building the new one. To set the frame size for desktop, tablet, and mobile, I follow the bootstrap grid with 12 columns on large and medium screens and 6 on small screens. There are hundreds of free UI kits and templates online, but I personally prefer using my own one and maybe grab a few elements from other UI kits. Now, let's talk about plugins. Plugins provide simple and intuitive ways to speed up your work, automate repetitive tasks, and they are super easy to install. Now, I'm going to show you how I create these simple illustrations in 3 steps using 3 plugins. So, here we go! How I use pages, assets, resources, and plugins. As promised, here's my 3 tips to help you collaborating in Figma. If you don't want to let your clients see what you're doing in real time, make sure you only share the preview and not the actual file. Often my clients want to see how the page will look with real copy, but because I don't want to let them edit my Figma files, I use a super useful plugin called Google Sheet Sync. All you need to do is to create a Google Sheet and link it to your Figma file. You can find out more about this tool in the description below. Bring your clients and developers on board and make sure they understand how Figma works. I usually send them a document explaining my design process, how to use this tool, and the benefits of using my system. You can download it, it's in the description below. Inviting developers to view your Figma file can sound intimidating, but it helps promote transparency and better collaboration as they can leave notes, download assets, inspect elements, just make sure you let them view the file instead of edit. Now, let me know in the comments below how you use Figma with your clients, developers, or colleagues. And if you want to see more videos like this, make sure you click the subscribe button, like this video, and share it with your friends, as it really helps to support this channel. Thank you for watching. I hope you learned something new today, and I'll see you in the next video. Ciao!